Hello children, I am Dr. Aruna Mohan, retired professor from Delhi University, and today we are going to discuss role of natural selection in evolving adaptations through activity. Children, you know about natural selection, you know about adaptations also, and now you will appreciate Darwin's theory of natural selection, where he started with overproduction, struggle for existence, and survival of the fittest. What do we mean by survival of fittest? The person who can adjust with the environment will survive, and who will not adjust with the environment, who will not adjust with the environment may not survive successfully. What is the meaning of survival here? Those who adapt with the environment, and that is called adaptations. And these adaptations are evolved through natural selection. So natural selection definitely has a role in selecting the adaptations. That is what we are going to discuss today through activity. This is a very simple activity designed to prove this particular fact. For this, children, you will take some hard paper or chart paper and make the pieces say 2 square inches. After you have prepared these blocks or squares, then with the help of pen you will write alphabets A, B, C up to Z, and this you will do 10 times. That means you will have 260, that is 260 such cards with letters written on it. This activity is very interesting. But before I begin how to perform this activity, I would like to remind you children that there is something called sickle cell anemia, and you are also aware of malaria. Now these two diseases are prevalent in African populations, and that is why sickle celled RBCs are more in African population. In this case, it is a sort of adaptation, though the fact is if RBCs are sickle shaped, then they will carry less hemoglobin, hence less oxygen. That is the disadvantage, but it has one advantage, that the persons who are having sickle celled RBCs will not contract malaria, that means will not suffer of malaria or sickle cell anemia. And that is required in African population because these two diseases are prevalent in African continent. Now, who will get sickle celled RBCs? You are aware of the fact that there is something called allele on chromosomes, and each allele is identified to control some character in our body. Coming to hemoglobin and sickle celled RBCs, if it is HbA and HbA, you are normal individual, and if it is HbS, then the person is sickled celled or having sickled celled RBCs. And if one is HbA and HbS, that is heterozygous, that person is a carrier but will not contract malaria or sickle cell anemia. Also, I would like to give you a little detail about sickle cell anemia. In sickle cell RBC, the hemoglobin is sickle shaped and it will carry less oxygen and it will lead to anemia. So that is sickle cell anemia. But if he is heterozygous, HbA and HbS, then he will not suffer of anemia. He will not suffer of malaria also, but he is a carrier and he is heterozygous. In short, heterozygous population will not suffer these two diseases which are prevalent in African population. Why he will not get malaria? Because when mosquito bites you and malaria germs, plasmodium goes into your blood, this plasmodium will enter your RBCs and then enter the hemoglobin and then divide. If hemoglobin is sickle shaped, then this plasmodium will not be able to divide in the hemoglobin, because hemoglobin is not enough and he will not get enough nutrition. And that is why this heterozygous condition will also be saving malaria contraction, means the person will not suffer of malaria. After giving you this much of background, now I would like to explain how we are going to conduct experiment. The experiment we will conduct in three steps, and this is step number one. I have already made 260 cards with ABCD written on them, 10 sets, that means 260 such cards. Now I will mix them in a bowl. This is experiment number one. So I am mixing them in random way. Without any order, all are mixed. I would also like to inform you that appearing adaptations in the population is a non-random process. It is not a random process, first thing. Second thing, natural selection has very important role in fixing adaptations and in evolving adaptations. What is the meaning of the word evolving adaptations here? The meaning is, if there is a useful adaptation, then it remains with the population, and if it is not useful, it disappears, and nature has role in this, and that is why we say natural selection in evolving adaptations. So in experiment one, we will first make a word, say cat or mat or bat, that is, I am taking the word cat, C-A-T. Now after deciding the word cat, that is a kind of adaptation we are trying to have. We will take three cards at random without seeing. I have taken one card and two and three. Let us see what letters we have got. We have got one H, one B and one Y. That means we have not got the cat. Now this I will put in another bowl and take another three. If two comes together, then you do it again. We have got one G, one J and one B. Again, we did not get the cat. Let me tell you, in this kind of procedure, in this kind of experiment, the chances are, even if I take out all the cards, 3, 3, 3, I may not get the word cat. I will do 2-3 more times, and I will tell you why we will not get, unless there is a miracle. Again, I am keeping in a different bowl, and again I take 3. 1. 2 and 3. So I got T, I got A, I got I. Again the word cat is not there. So this adaptation will not come so easily in the natural selection. So the probable role of selection process in evolving meaningful adaptation. What is the meaning of meaningful adaptation? In our case, in this experiment, it is cat, the word cat. Otherwise, it will be real adaptation to survive in the particular environment. So, in this case, we could not form the word cat because natural selection is not able to select the adaptations which is required. And that is what is happening in nature. Not every adaptation will be selected. As I told you, the adaptation is a non-random process. It is not a random process. So this was experiment one, which if I try to conclude, that even if we take out all the cards, we take out 100 times, even then the word cat will not be formed. If it is formed, it is only a miracle. Naturally, it will not form. Now I move to experiment number two. Again, I mix all the cards. Now, the word cat you remember. We change our strategy. As usual, we will take out 3 cards because the word cat has 3 letters, so I can't take more than 3 cards. So I take 3 cards. Let me mix it properly. I put these cards here for a while to mix. So whatever I had taken out was not at the top, and now they are again haphazardly mixed. Now I take 3. As I was taking in the experiment 1, the same way I take 3 cards in experiment number 2. Now I have got 1 V, 1 K and 1 H. What I am going to do in this is that the word cat is C-A-T. Now any of this letter comes, suppose C comes and A-T doesn't come, I will select or I will take that C and put in this bowl. I will take out another 3 first. This I can put in this bowl, and now let me see what I have taken. E, F, I. Again, any useful letter is not here. The required letter is not here. Again, I discard them. 1, 2, 3. I have got X, I have got M, and I have got Z. Again, essential letter I required. The required word in our case is C, A, T. So these 3 letters I am looking for. C, A, T. That is one adaptation for our experiment. So the 3 cards which I have taken out, they are X, M and Z. Again, I will discard them because I don't require them. 1, 2, 3. So I have A, I have Y, and I have I. Now, one letter has come which is useful for me, essential letter. It is not a word, but C-A-T has A. What I will do, I will put back this A in the main container and discard these 2. Again, I take out. I will take out 2 or 3 times more, and then I will explain what I am trying to do in this experiment. So I have A, G and J. Again, my useful essential letter is A, which I am putting back. Sometimes I may get 2 letters. Suppose I take out M and A and T, then A and T, 2 are essential. 1, 2, 3. So I have K, I have A, yes, and T. So for me, 2 are essential now, A and T. I will put back these 2 and discard this one. One more time I will take and then explain to you. 1, 2, 3. I have got O, I have got F, I have got R. So no essential letter is here. So all the 3 are discarded. One more time I am taking, and after that we discuss this particular point. These 2 had come, so I'll change. It should be 1. G, T and J. That is, T is essential, C-A-T, T, and I discard these 2. We will do this kind of stepping for all the cards. So a time will come when in this particular container I will have either C or A or T cards. Do you agree with me? That we consume all the cards. So we are increasing the chances of getting C and A and T from this, because we are increasing that number, those letters more in this container. At that time, when you take out three cards, again necessarily it will not be CAT, it may be ACT or TAC, but chances are more that you get letter CAT formed in less draws. And now nature is selecting. That means nature will accumulate the adaptations, and once nature has accumulated, you have more chances of having that adaptation gene in your body or in the next generation. So, in first experiment, chances were nil. Even if we were taking 100 times, we may not form the word cat because we were returning it to this container. Now, what we were returning to this container? Only essential letters which form CAT. So, at one time, you will have only either C or A or T, and all other cards we have discarded here. So, chances are more. So, this is experiment number 2. Now, we come to experiment number 3. I am putting back these discarded cards here, and one more time I mix them. You can either put in big container or you can put on the table also and do, but we should not see what is written on the card. I am putting it this way because in third experiment we need to spread it more. Now, in third experiment, we will again pick three cards. Our word is cat, 2 and 3. And what are my letters? N, V, and another N. Okay? We discard them. Again, I take 3. Without looking into the card. By mistake, I took 2, so I am discarding it here and I am taking another. F, I, and U. We again discard them. We will take 3 cards each unless we get useful letters C, A, and T. Again, 2 have come, so I will take another. In nature, if 2 will come together, that individual will not survive. V, P, and K, again, we discard. V, X, and Y. So, again, this will be discarded. What I am going to do, children, this, whenever I get useful word C or A or T, I put it back here. And if I get 2 letters out of 3, C, A, T, if I get C, A, or I get C, T, or I get A, T, then I will clip them and put them together. And then I will explain you why I am doing this. In fact, in genetics, you have learned the process of inversion. When 2 genes are inverted, then inversion reduces the crossing over. That means these 2 genes are linked, and if they are linked, they will move from one generation to another generation in linked condition. That means 2 genes are moving together. So, whenever I get 2 letters out of 3, I will clip them, and if I get 1, I will just put it back, and which I clip, that also I put back. So, we have tendencies of clipped characters or linked characters that will further help in getting the word cat quickly, rather more quickly than the previous one. So, I wish I get the clipped ones. 1, 2, and again 2 have come, so I will take 1. L, Y, and X, I will discard them. 1, I should not see, 2, and 3. Again, S, S and B. I discard them. So, children, we are conducting the experiment number 3 to find out how natural selection will take the adaptation or fix the adaptation. I am again taking out 3 cards. One is T, other is also T, then one is A. Okay. So, our word is CAT. Now, out of C and A and T, we have T, which we can take one T, and we have got A. Now, these two essential letters I am going to clip. And put it back. And T is also essential, I will put it also back. Again, I am taking 3. I have one E, I have one A, and I have one C. So, what are essential letters for us? A and C, not E. So, I will take A and C, I clip them. E is not essential for us. So, I discard it. In previous draw, I had put the T back, one single T, because that was essential. I will do one more time and after that I explain it. 1, 2, and 3. So, again I have R, M and N. So, I discard them. So, children, you can very easily imagine that by this process, I will have all essential letters here and all discarded one here. But there is difference between experiment number 2 and experiment number 3. In that, I was putting individual letters back to the main container. Here, I am clipping them if there are 2 letters in one row which is essential for me. Out of CAT, if I have 2 letters, I clip them. Now, after doing it many times, when I have either clipped or essential or desired letters, then if I clip any 3, so if I am clipping one, suppose by chance one clipped one and one single one, 2 had come, so normal. So it is Q and now A and C. Again I put it back, this clipped one, and put this which is not desired here. Now, chances of making word cat become very fast. Why? Because you have clipped characters or you have linked characters. So, this is how nature acts. Nature will first look for good adaptation, and that adaptation nature will try to fix 1 time, 2 times, 3 times, 100 times, 1000 times. And when nature has fixed that adaptation so many times, that adaptation now exists in the nature. And if there is a linked gene, then it is easier for nature to fix that adaptation. So, natural selection is the process where nature is fixing essential adaptations. You can very well imagine, if nature had not done this, then evolution could not take place, because adaptation has great role in evolution. So, natural selection is playing its role in evolving adaptations, first creating adaptation, then evolving adaptation. In some previous episodes, you have learned that mutation is the base for evolution. And whenever mutation takes place, this is change, sudden change in genetic material, hence the character will change. When character changes, this can be either fatal if it is bad one, it can be mediocre or it can be very good one. Where it is good one, it is maintained, and this good one is adaptation. So, this adaptation should be maintained, and this is how the nature will maintain it in evolving adaptations. This is the reason that evolution has taken place. Starting with amoeba, we went to multicellular organisms, then all the invertebrates, then fishes, the first vertebrate, then amphibians, reptiles, and on one side, birds, and other side, mammals. In mammals also, we the human beings are the last to come on land as evolved individuals. So, unless mutation had taken place, unless adaptations appeared, unless the nature fixed these adaptations and evolved the adaptations for evolution, evolution could not be possible. And also, nature has done one more good thing, that whichever adaptation was not good, that was removed. And hence, only good adaptations are fixed. And this is called evolving adaptations by natural selection. So, children, we have done this experiment in three steps. In experiment number one, the selection was less. In two, it was more. And three, it was still more. So, this particular experiment, of course, I have shown you few draws. But when you do in the class, you draw till the cards are there. So, in third one, because genes are linked, that's why you will make the word cat very fast. So, this is the role of natural selection in evolving adaptations, because evolution moves through mutation, followed by adaptation, followed by evolution. So, adaptations have great role to play in natural selection and also in evolution. And that is the reason from amoeba, multicellular organisms are formed, then all the invertebrates, then first vertebrate, fish, and then amphibians, and then reptiles, and from reptiles evolved on one side the birds and on other side the mammals. In mammals also, we were not the first to come. All other mammals came before us and we were the last to come. So, it is a process of adaptation and evolution which is still going on. It is a continuous process, and from us, the human beings, definitely some improved organism will come depending upon the kind of adaptations which natural selection evolved and fixed. With this, we come to the end of this episode.